Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Kori Ashton here in San Antonio, Texas at WebTegrity, and this is another WordPress Wednesday where every single Wednesday I'm bringing to you a tutorial video on how to improve your WordPress website. And today I want to kind of teach you how to use the Visual Composer page builder a little bit further. I already have a video that gives you kind of the basics overall of what the capabilities are of the Visual Composer. If you haven't seen that yet, check out the description box below and I'll put the link in there to that video. But this one's actually going to take you step by step through how to make a certain page template layout. And I'm going to show you, I'm going to use this exact same template that I have here, this theme going on. This looks pretty boring, right? I mean, very simple, minimalist, which is nice, but at the same time, you definitely want to have some sort of a wow factor happening on your website. And a lot of times, you've already got so much content in here, you've already spent so much time and effort into this one particular theme, you might not want to change themes to have something cool happen. Check this out. This is the exact same theme. I'm going to slide off the screen so you can just check out the page. I want you to see the header here with these icons. This is the exact same theme. Now I have an edge-to-edge parallax cool layout. I've got the three columns. I've got a cool little quote area and then a masonry blog area. How nice is that? This is the exact same theme still I'm using here. All done with the Visual Composer. So let's see how I did it. Of course, you would purchase the Visual Composer. I have a link to that in the description box below. You would install it just like you would any normal premium plugin and activate it. Once you have it activated, you can go to your pages or posts and just click Add New. For now, I'm going to ask you to just create a new blank page just to start to learn the Visual Composer. Try not to use this on an existing page just yet. I just want you to kind of get used to it. When you have this activated, and I'm just going to say I'm testing this page. When you have the plugin activated, now you've got these two new options sitting here, and we want to use the backend editor. See that again? This is the backend editor. Once I do that, it kind of takes over this area and allows us to do some cool dragging and dropping. So I'm going to add an element. This is the step-by-step tutorial to get it to look like this. I'm going to add an element. I'm going to add a row. Now this is going to stretch as far as the page will allow it to stretch. So if I want it to stretch edge to edge, there is one thing that your theme has to allow, and it has to have an inside page template called full width. So how you check that is over here. Inside of page, you'll go to template on the right side, open this up, and see if you have a full width option. If you do, that will allow the content to stretch edge to edge. So be sure to have that setting set in place. Now what I'd like to do is put in our call to action block here. So I'm going to click the plus sign in the middle of my new row, and here is our call to action. I'm going to click that. I'm just going to use the default content that's sitting in there for now, but one of the things I am going to do is I'm going to add a button to the bottom of this area, and as soon as you do that, you have this button option that comes into play here. I'm going to click that, and just take time to read through each one of these tabs to see all the different options that you can do. Because you can really get creative with how you set these things to look. So we want to have that link there, and so I've set the link together. The style, I'm just going to say classic. I'm going to keep the same rounded color. I want to change the size. I want it to be large. So you can go through every single one of these settings. If you want to add that phone icon, you can click there and add the icon. For now, I'm just going to go ahead and click Save Changes. So let's see what this looks like currently on the front side of my website. I'm going to click Save Draft, and let's go ahead and preview and see what we're up to. So all right, so we've got this block that sits there kind of like this, but we don't have a picture in there yet. So how do we get a background picture to stretch this full width? The thing that's really cool about Visual Composer is that we have layers. That's what's really amazing about this. Everything sits in layers. So we have our call to action text that sits on the front side. Now we want to put a picture behind it. So here's how you get to that area. Here's our call to action area here. Right behind it, now we want to affect this row, which is this slight gray area. We want to click on this pencil icon that affects the row behind it. And we want to stretch that row, not the content inside of it, we just want to stretch the row itself. And scrolling down, of course, you can see all the other options, but we definitely want a parallax in this area. We just want it to be a simple parallax. This is where we set the image for what sits behind us. The image that I'm using is size 1280 by 400. And I'm going to click Set Image. And that's going to put that image in there, and I'm going to go ahead and click Save Changes and kind of let you see where we are so far. Now, if I'm moving too quickly, just pause the video, rewind it, and kind of go through this step by step. But I want to get through this pretty quickly so you can see how the results end up. So here we go, edge to edge, beautiful. And now, of course, on my example, I have a little bit more padding in there. So how do we get that in there? We'll go ahead and go to, again, behind the scenes, the background area. And we have design options here. And just for the sake of this layout, I went ahead and put in 150 pixels on the top of our text and 150 pixels on the bottom of our text. And I'm going to click Save Changes. Save Draft, of course, because we're just doing this for the sake of an example. Click Preview. And now we've got our beautiful padding, just like our example, you guys. Isn't that amazing? Well, so let's see what we can do now with three columns. I'm going to move through this a little bit more quickly even. I'm going to add a new row. New row. Inside of this row, I'm going to have our, actually, we can just take this row to three columns. Check this out. One, two, three. There are three columns. How'd I do that? I hovered over this little second icon that allows you to have totally different layouts in these rows. This particular layout allows me to have three columns. I'm going to click Add Something New to this column, and I'm just going to add a simple image. Right here is our simple image, and I'm going to click Add Image. And these are our images here that we're playing around with. Set image. And we can give it a title and we can say meet the team or whatever you'd like it to say. This is where you go ahead and set the size of this picture. And for the sake of this design, I'm going to go ahead and say full. You have other options here, so just go ahead and read through them. I'm going to say center the image alignment. Do we want it to link anywhere? Yes, I want it to link to my page called Our Team. And of course, you can do any of the links here. You just figure out what link you want it to go to and drop it in there. And we want it to be in the same page. And we're just going to go ahead and click Save Changes. So there's our image. Now, if we wanted to not have to set every single one of those things the same over and over again, you can duplicate this. Check this out. I'm going to click the middle icon that duplicates that image. I'm going to duplicate it again. Then I can drag and drop them. Oh, how cool is this, you guys? Then, of course, we don't want the exact same image there, so I'm going to click on the little pencil icon that takes me in and allows me to change out what image I do want in there. And these images are 714 by 500. And I'm going to click Save, and then this image needs to change as well. And let's see what else we have in here for an image. Let's do that one. Why not? Set. Okay. Oh, that's the same one. We want a different one. Let's try this one. Why not? Set image. All right, and save changes. So let's see what the front side's starting to look like. We've got our testing area. Oh, wow, these aren't nearly as big as what we'd like them to be. So this is, again, where you start to play around with the row settings, and we want to stretch the content. So the row here, we definitely want to stretch the row and the content, and you just want to play around with the different settings inside of this thing. But that helps you kind of understand. There you go, meet the team, and of course, we wanted to change that title as well. And they all link somewhere, so that's cool. And you can put text boxes down below them. You just want to play and have fun. I want to add something to this column. So I'm going to click the little plus icon, and I'm going to add a text block to this column. And for the sake of this, I'm just going to leave it with the default text. I'm going to duplicate it, drag, and drop it underneath this next image. I'm going to duplicate it, drag, and drop it under this next image. And click Preview again, and let's go see what it's looking like now, you guys. Look at this. It looks so much like our example. How fun is that? That's how this works. You just keep going down the page, playing around with all the different elements that are available inside the Visual Composer. I hope this has helped you. If you have questions specifically about the Visual Composer, realize that because you've purchased it, you have access to their support team. So you can come here to support and connect with them the way they're asking you to connect with them. I am not support for Visual Composer. I just do these videos so that I can help y'all improve your websites online. So check them out. Go there. Connect with them. I'll put the link specifically to this tab in the links below. Hope you're having a great WordPress Wednesday. I will see y'all next week. Bye, y'all.